Welcome to The Snapshot, our series which examines the forces driving global commodity markets. Late October saw a momentous decision from the International Maritime Organization, the branch of the UN that regulates global shipping. The IMO announced a 2020 start date for a global cap of 0.5% sulfur content in marine fuels, down from 3.5% currently. This ended years of uncertainty over whether implementation would be pushed back to 2025 or go ahead in 2020. But now, the step change down to tighter sulfur specifications at sea will have knock-on effects throughout the global refining and energy system. Currently, nearly all ships run on fuel oil, a residual product from the refining process. But in order to meet the 0.5% cap, many analysts anticipate large-scale switching to middle distillates-based fuels. The IEA sees marine sector demand for gas oil jumping by 2 million barrels per day in 2020 to reach 2.7 million barrels per day, and a roughly corresponding drop in residual fuel oil demand. However, no one really knows the share of distillates versus residual that will be used globally to meet the 0.5% cap. Informed estimates range from 50-50 to 90-10, which leaves huge uncertainty over the extra cost to the shipping industry, anywhere between $10 billion and $50 billion extra per year. The study commissioned by the IMO to base its decision on says that the world refining system will have the capacity to meet the extra demand for distillates, even while road use grows. But according to a rival study by consultants Ensis and Navigistics, the refining system could be severely strained, and all refined product prices worldwide could be boosted by $10 per barrel to nearly $20 per barrel. You would think this would be great news for all refineries, but with high sulfur fuel oil cracks expected to plummet in 2020, simple refineries with high levels of fuel oil output will suffer. Russia, a huge fuel oil exporter, was among the countries pushing for the IMO to delay the start date by 5 years, and now faces a race against time to upgrade its refineries to produce higher value products before demand for fuel oil shrinks dramatically. Global trade flows will also be affected. Only Asia is expected to be self-sufficient for the new 0.5% blend. The Americas, Europe, and Africa will probably be net importers of the fuel, with the Middle East emerging as the main exporting region. Clean products will also be affected, with Europe likely to become even shorter of middle distillates. In the crude markets, the global sulfur cap suggests a lower future value for heavy sour grades, such as from unconventional Canadian and Venezuelan production. For more details, check out our special report on Platts.com. And until next time on The Snapshot, we'll be keeping an eye on the markets.